But it's refreshing to see a new perspective on life. You know, she's only been around 3 years, and the way that she sees things is with an open curiosity. It's just really refreshing.
My name is Emily Schoen. I'm a dancer and choreographer based out of Brooklyn, New York. I create contemporary dance work that highlights the aesthetics of the people in the room. As an artist, we are in this unique position to contribute to society from a very personal and human level. In 2017, I went on a Dance Motion USA tour with Kegwin & Company in Tunisia. I was delighted to find people that are working in a similar vein to how we work in New York. I thought there might be an opportunity to dive deeper into exploration with these artists. With some help from the US Embassy, I went back 6 months later with people from my company to dive in a little bit more and kind of find where these different voices intersect. And now, 2 years later, we were able to get artist visas for these dancers, and we were able to expand the work we started into an evening-length production. We were going to do it all in like a 3-week process with the premiere the fourth week. And then this Backspace residency came along as a beautiful gift that extended our process. It's not about me creating material and teaching it, and it's not even about these guests creating their own material and teaching us, because again, that's not our strength. So it's kind of finding that intersection and having this space and this extra time has really allowed us to really be true to finding movement that's a blend of ours. I'm from Brookfield, Wisconsin, in the Midwest of the United States. A bit of a bubble. And I think the more people I see and the more cultures I experience, the more I want work to be inclusive and representative of the human experience in general. I'm a big podcast lover. When I'm commuting, I'm usually listening to someone. We're folding in a lot of audio stories from the dancers' experiences growing up, kind of showing these unique anecdotes from everyone's lives to illustrate a shared humanity. I think my consumption of podcasts over the years is folding into the work from a very practical sense. After we premiere our work in Queens, we might be taking the work back to Tunisia, which would be a beautiful circular process, circular journey. I'm also thinking once we have this show up and running, we can continue to bring it to festivals in Europe, kind of be the meeting place from these artists in New York and artist space in Tunisia.